Hello, this is Solar Business TV once again from Intersolar India 2019 from Bangalore. And now it's a special moment because at least, you know, we can speak with one woman entrepreneur, with Rashi Gupta, Dr. Rashi Gupta, who created her company 10 years ago. And it's also quite interesting because this is not like, you know, solar panel manufacturer, but this is battery storage company. So, Rashi, hello.
Hello, thank you so much for being here on my booth. I simply enjoyed hosting you here.
So, actually, we just met with Rashi because she liked so much solar moda, you know.
Yes, I simply loved it.
Suit, yes. And then I saw there is a very brilliant, shiny person. And actually, she's an entrepreneur. Yes, so can you tell us more about your company?
Yeah, I founded Vision Mechatronics in 2009. And we primarily started off as a robotics and industrial automation company. And when I saw that there is like, I need more innovation and something to bring value to my country, I started in 2015 with energy storage. And we are the pioneers in India for lithium batteries with active balancing, which increases the efficiency and life of the batteries, along with preventive monitoring systems, everything completely made in India. And with preventive monitoring, we are now offering features of like 15 days advance, we can tell our customers that the batteries are going to go bad. So that really helps. Mm-hmm. Over a period of time, maybe if I have more data collection now over the next 2 years, I may even be able to predict much earlier that the batteries are going to go bad.
So, how does it work, you know, in India for women to be a businesswoman?
That's a tricky question. Yes, I mean, when I started late back in 2009, 10 years back, there were no women entrepreneurs in the technology field. There were very rare women enterprises that you can see in a technology field. Today, yes, things are opening up. There are more women entrepreneurs coming up. But still, India is lacking behind with women entrepreneurs. We need to empower them a little more.
Exactly. So you said that you have 1%, yes?
Yes.
Of the Indian market. So when you will have 10%?
Within the next 2 to 3 years, that's the target.
What is your business model actually?
My product portfolio includes batteries and storage systems for the EVs and the stationary storage. In the stationary storage, we mainly try and help the end user and the EPC companies to reduce their EPC time with our product called as One Box, which is an all-integrated system and a plug-and-play device. Then in the EV segment, we have a very advanced batteries with which we can increase the range of the vehicle with a very lightweight battery. There's one product which we have just launched with Intersolar this year, which is called Li-Link, which is energy bank for EVs, which is just like your mobile battery bank. You just plug it and you can just have your phone charged.
It's very, not heavyweight, yeah?
No, it's very, very light. I can lift it. Oh. If I can lift it, it is sorted.
No, but you know, like a businesswoman, entrepreneur, you have a lot of strength, huh?
I have to have strength, otherwise how will my business run? I have to do that.
But you tell me also that you are working with the government, yes?
Yes, I am a committee member with Bureau of Indian Standards. I am doing my little bit contribution towards writing the global standards also. I'm a part of IEC committees as well. I've been closely working with the ministries to improve the situation of solar and energy storage in India. I've also contributed my bit to the National Energy Storage Mission.
And how many women entrepreneurs you have in this industry?
In the energy storage? Not many. I think I'm the first pioneer. And thanks to the industry's love and affection, they call me as Battery Valley of India.
Ah, okay.
Yes. And I sincerely appreciate all the love affection that the industry has given me for the work that I've done.
So you have a solar bike, yes?
Yes, we have an e-bike. E-bike. This can be charged with solar. And this is one of its kind because this has a highest range. And this is a product segment positioned in between a cycle and a motorcycle. So it's in between that. It gives you a very high range. It gives you a very high stop speed. And it is a very efficient method to transfer, to roam around in the city. And it uses only one unit to charge. And one unit is actually nothing in India to consider to charge.
And you also,
very super efficient.
And you have also like, you know, power wall, yes?
Yes, we
but
have
which
a power wall.
Apparently has some added value.
Yes, which has a lot of added value because it has four things combined together. It has a stabilizer function, it has a UPS function, it has an inverter grid feed function, as well as a battery bank. So when you there is a solar DC input to it. So when you combine all of these together, you have one product which replaces four of these. And being a plug-and-play device, it's very easy to install. I mean, you can finish the installation maybe within a couple of hours.
And we met at the booth of a Chinese company. Yes. And how do you cope, being competitor of Chinese companies? Do you think that you have an opportunity to be, successful?
Yes, of course. Being an Indian company, people have more faith in you here. As an Indian company, people have more faith in you. You are established. They have been seeing us time and again over the years. And not all Chinese companies are bad. I would say that, yes, you have to be very selective with your Chinese partners and you have to be very sure of the business models.
Okay, but recently we launched the Empowering Women initiative
around the
world, yes? I would like to ask you, because I don't have to ask you if you join, because you will join us.
Oh, yes, we will join you.
But what would be, your recommendation to women in India? How they can start their adventure in the cleantech industry?
See, in a cleantech industry, we definitely need more women. Women entrepreneurs are good managerial force. And Indian women in particular, because we Indian women are brought up with the cultural value to take care of our homes. And if somebody can take care of the home, they can definitely take care of the office. And we need more such, women managers are much better. They can empathize better. And to come into cleantech, I would sincerely request all the women who have interest in renewable energy, do start your cleantech business. And if anybody needs any support from me, I'm there.
Last thing, you know what is our flagship sign?
What?
Thumbs up for solar.
Thumbs up for solar.
Thumbs up for solar, for Rashi, for her company, and for all the women entrepreneurs in India. Thumbs up.